climbing high into the sun. Here they come, zooming to meet our thunder. Adam, boys, give it the gun. Down we dive, spouting a flame from under. Off with one terrible roar. We live in fame, or go down in flame.
Boy, nothing can stop the Army Air Corps.
Clear! Clear! Contact! Contact! Those who love the vastness of the sky, to a friend we will send a message of his brother men who fly.
Thank to those who gave their all of old, and down we roar before the rainbow
high. A toast to the host of men we boast, the Army Air Corps.
I got this many, many years after the war. I did not get a scratch during my service in World War II, thankfully. Good evening. My name is Ray Chan, and I am the kid brother of Jones, who was being talked about just a while ago. During World War II, at which I served, I was a radio operator in the Army Air Corps. I was not an officer, I was an enlisted man. And my overseas service was over in Burma. If anyone know about Burma? Well, I flew on C-47s. Which was an unarmed cargo airplane, flying supplies and troops to the battlefield. I served in Burma almost exclusively. I'll tell you about one battle in the heart of Burma. If any one of you know Burma, you might know Michinaw, which is in the northern part of Burma, between China and India. We were stationed in the right-hand corner of India, and we were making flights over to save the airfield at Michinaw. That whoever controls that would really control the war over in Burma. We fought for many months, and just about the time that we have it secured, we had a surprise battle or a call for a battle in China. What happened was the war in Germany was just about over, and the Japanese were going to make a last big push to try to capture China before the Americans and the Allies come over to help China. So Japanese were making a final big push over, and we were flying supply over the Hump, over the. So one day, our commander asked us who would like to go over to China on an emergency flight. And me, being of Chinese ancestry, just looking forward to it. So I volunteered to make one of those flights, flying supplies, and my flight was the Chinese soldiers whom I tried to speak to, not very well, but I was able to speak to some of the officers who understood a few English words, and I understood a few Chinese words. So we did have a short conversation. To get over to China, we had to fly over the Himalayas, you know that. And we could used to call that the Hump. So one morning, after we loaded the Chinese soldiers over there and supplies, I was a radio operator, keeping in touch with our station, and with two pilots who are going to make that flight over to China. Flying over there was easy. We flew alongside the Hump, I would say, maybe about 6 or 8,000 feet between the Farias Mountains Hump. No problem at all. So we got there at lunchtime, and we had a quick bite, and the three of us were saying, gee, how about making another flight over here tomorrow, quick like, and we can stay here longer and visit with Chinese and China. So all three of us agreed to it, two pilots and myself. And we came back the same day that we flew over the Hump. But by God, in the afternoon, the weather changed completely. And it got darkened real quick, so we could not find the way through the Hump that we came over with. We had to fly very high. So I think that our pilots had to fly some 14 or 15,000 feet without oxygen and for hours on end. And without oxygen, I would say you don't feel any different. Maybe you don't even feel yourself. But all I know is that after all the calls I made to India and Chabwar, that's a big aerial supply base, we made connection and we finally made it back to India with a gallon of gas left, so they told me. And I was hoping to make our flight to China and stay a week. Instead, I was in bed for 3 days for lack of oxygen. That's the truth. I don't know what I was short of, but all I know is that I'm sorry I never made or stayed in China. But we made it through World War II and come back. Thank you very much. I'm very proud and probably bragging about all these, but these are the trophies I got, all the medals that I got in the service. If you want to come in and inspect it yourself, thank you very much.
Services and all the other veterans. I'm a little choky right now.